Meet North Carolina's Angela Cacace. This powerhouse is a carpenter, designer, builder, and owner of her own remodel business in a male-dominated industry.
9% of the construction industry as a whole are women.
So naturally, she had to overcome obstacles. But interestingly, Angela wasn't always in the construction field.
I actually was a barber in Washington, D.C. for 10 years.
But after moving to North Carolina for her husband's job, she put the scissors down and set a goal to remodel their home.
My husband was a little bit more reluctant because I had no remodel experience whatsoever.
But she took it on anyway, and after she built the deck with her dad, she tackled the kitchen on her own.
I was very much so like on the job training. I definitely watched my share of YouTube videos. I hired an electrician, I hired a plumber, I hired a tiler, but I tackled all the carpentry.
She single-handedly put in the work as she took on the demo, built the cabinets, breakfast nook, custom pieces.
Managing the project and doing the design, it all came together. And it was amazing.
It turned out so amazing that she had to do a little gloating.
Remember, my husband was not very like excited about me tackling this. The cherry on top was afterwards I had taken pictures and he was showing a coworker. So his coworker was like, your wife should submit these pictures to this old house.
Which you may recognize from their magazine or the PBS show.
And I ended up winning their national competition for kitchen remodel. So that was really satisfying.
And throughout the process, she fell in love with carpentry. So she enrolled in classes and eventually decided she wanted to start her own business, which wasn't always easy.
As a woman, it was like I was going into it, but I was so intimidated to actually pursue it as a profession.
But with the help of one of her teachers, she got her first clients and dove in.
That was back in 2017, and it's been so much fun.
But of course, it didn't come without its challenges.
It's a constant battle to try to prove to people that I am the boss, I'm in charge, and I'm here to get the job done.
And she says even trying to buy a truck for her tools was difficult.
The guy that I was buying the truck from wouldn't even talk to me. My husband had to repeatedly tell him, this is my wife's truck, you need to talk to her. She's the one buying the truck.
Through her persistence and hard work, she has overcome adversity, and now she is helping other women do the same by creating Move Over Bob.
It's a website dedicated to showcasing stories and inspiring resources for other women to try to get into the construction and trades industry.
Angela has now connected tradeswomen from all over the world and hopes to
continue building this idea of like women just being happy and championing for other women. I mean, really, the sky's the limit when there's so much work to be done.
Overcoming obstacles and smashing stereotypes is at the top of the list.